Hi, I'm Andrew Curran, and I'm HSE's Chief Scientific Advisor and Director of Research. And I'm here today in our burn hall, which is one of the facilities that we use to help support the delivery of HSE's strategy, protecting people and places. Our burn hall has a thermal rating of about 3 megawatts for continuous fires, and that's like a big garden bonfire, and up to 5 megawatts for short bursts. And we use this facility to help us test new materials and new processes so that the risks can be managed effectively whilst we learn about the properties of those materials that then feeds into risk assessments, etc. And this is one of the facilities we use when doing work in support of HSE's strategic objective around trust, to ensure that people feel safe where they live, where they work, and in their environment. We've used this facility to help our building safety colleagues develop the safety case approach for high-rise buildings. And our scientists, engineers, and analysts have also produced evidence guides on key building materials, such as concrete, steel, timber, masonry, polymers, and glass. And this provides information on their degradation, their failure, how to inspect, and maintenance. And all of that feeds into the safety case approach. Moving to the evidence needs for our work on the wider environment, it's important that we connect and collaborate with colleagues from around the world. This includes the work we've been doing with the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, where we've been working with international experts to update the OEC guidance on toxicity data from chemicals. We've also been working with Norwegian, Swedish, and French agencies to model the potential hazards of toxic industrial chemical leaks to help the modelling that underpins our land use planning advice. Our annual science review includes these and many other examples of our work, so if you want to learn more, please download a copy, and the information is available on the screen now.